Kuzuzambo and welcome to my presentation. My name is Passang Tshering. So today I'm going to present on my October month research that I've carried out on the the potential use of quinoa in a school feeding program and judging the school feeding program as a healthy public policy in the country. So before going to my presentation, I want to highlight on the outline of the presentation. Firstly, I will touch on the introduction of the crop, because the crop quinoa seems at large scale unknown and unaware to most of the Bhutanese the people, especially who are not in touch with the soil for the agriculture production in the country. The major proportion of the Bhutanese population. Secondly, I will touch on the nutritional composition of quinoa. After that, we'll go to the body of this presentation. That's why and the reason behind that the quinoa commodity, the crop, should be included, or the potential use of this quinoa in the school feeding program. Under this topic, we'll have several. Roughly around five topic or the area where the quinoa has a potential and the potential to help or boost or highlight the major agriculture production system in the country. And then lastly, I will conclude this presentation with whether the school feeding program in the country is a public healthy public policy or not. Lastly, in the introduction part, quinoa, with the scientific name of the Chinopodium album, is a domesticated crop in the Andean region in around 5,000 years ago. And the crop has been considered as one of the most promising crop for the human diet and the food security since 1996. The crop is a pseudo-cereal seed, considered to containing high nutritional value, and many paper and research findings have concluded or found out that the quinoa has a high genetic variability, meaning that the crop has lots of genetic varieties, and it has the huge potential for the adaptability under the diverse agroecological zones around the globe. The crop is also found to be a potential one in the global in fighting the hunger and malnutrition. In Bhutan, the quinoa crop has been introduced in 2015 with the support of the FAO, Food and Agriculture Organization, based office in Bhutan. If you observe the International Year of Quinoa in 2013 and 2015, based on the nutritional value and the aspect of the production aspect of the crop, it was introduced to Bhutan in 2015 through FAO. And since its introduction to the country, the detailed research, the variety evolution, research has been conducted led by the research center, particularly the National Center for Organic Agriculture based in Wispong, this is Thimphu. So the research findings have came out that there's the crop has a promising production and productivity under the Bhutanese farming condition. So over the years since its introduction in 2015 in the country, the area and production is found on the increase over the years. So if you look at the area and the production of the quinoa, the crop has came into the farmers condition production from 2017. So looking at this the graph shown on the screen, the area and the production is on the increasing over the years. As per the 2020 statistics R&D statistics, agriculture statistics. Since just within the 6 years of the crop introduction in the country, the crop found to be covering around 0.41% of the total cereal production, and 0.08% of the total cereal production in the country. So coming to the nutritional aspect of the quinoa, quinoa is found, the quinoa grain is found to contain around 12 to 23% of the protein, which is on an average comparing to the other crop is very high. 37% of the globulins and 35% albumins. There is a high content of cystein, arginine, and histidine. It is also one of the people have revealed that the 91 around 91.6%, roughly 92% of the raw quinoa protein is absorbable. There's the quinoa is found to contain 81.1 to 64.2 starch content, and the crop is the high solubility and digestibility starch. Beside the protein, amino acid, and other macronutrients contained, the quinoa is found to be gluten free. It is also one of the ideal amino acid source. So biological value of quinoa is 73%, which is almost similar to the beef, the meat beef, which is 74, but it's higher than the other cereal commodities, like rice. Rice has just around 56%, wheat 49, and corn. It's also found that with consumption of the quinoa, the crop has a potential of cancer prevent effect to the human due to the bioactive peptide called niacin. This is a rough a travel which which shows the different macronutrient and essential amino acid profile of quinoa and other selected crops, which is developed by with as per the report of the FAO. So if you look at it, energy, protein, fat, and total carbohydrate of quinoa is found much higher than the other major crops like bean, maize, rice, and wheat. So why quinoa in school feeding program? Firstly, there is a limited cropping system in the country. Cropping system meaning that the sequence of the crop under under cultivation in the particular area, the follow the system that the cropping system follow. So firstly, there is the potential for this crop to diversify the cropping system in the country. If you look at the potential to diversify potato, maize, and rice crop system, from the 12-5-year plan, the Ministry of Agriculture and Forests, the Department of Agriculture came to adopt the quinoa in the rice-based cropping system. Secondly, there is the huge potential to enhance the food and nutritional security of the Bhutanese people. Quinoa is considered to be the climate-resilient crop of the great nutritional value. It also offers the production scope of high-quality food. As per the World Food Program Score Index, around 8% of households in Bhutan have been a poor or the borderline diet, which means that around 8% of households in Bhutan has been poor, and the quinoa with potential to relieve short-term hunger and to elevate the micronutrient deficiency, which can have a direct effect in improving the education quality of the Bhutanese children. Thirdly, production of quinoa and inclusion on the large scale of production in the country can have an advantage in promoting and upscaling the local agriculture. As per the school feeding program, the white paper developed, it is the government have recommended that the Royal Government of Bhutan directed the Ministry of Agriculture and Forests and the Department of Education under the Ministry of Education to supply the locally produced quality food to the student. So based on that, based on these directives from the government, inclusion of quinoa in the school feeding program can promote and upskill our local agriculture production. It can promote, it can also stabilize the market, increase the farmers' income, and promote locally held food. Moreover, there is a scope for scope of area for developing and transforming the local agriculture through the proper linkage and coordination between the producer, that is farmer, and the buyers, that is where the school feeding program agency will link up. Moreover, many the paper on the school feeding program have stated that the school feeding program has advantage to the local communities, because as per the National Status Bureau report 2017, it said that the monthly per capita food consumption expenditure of the Bhutanese people is around 3,484. So moreover, the poverty analysis report 2017 stated that 8.2% of Bhutanese people are found to be poor, and of that portion, maximum major people who are found to be poor are in the rural area, with which stands at around 11.9%, roughly 10%, and 0.8% in urban areas. So with the well-designed school feeding program and inclusion of quinoa in school feeding program, there's advantage of benefiting our local communities, because it can provide benefits to health, education, local agriculture production, and household expenses. If the inclusion of the different commodities under the school feeding program, it can directly reduce the household level expenditure on the food consumption, because students or children will be fit with the healthier food in the school. So lastly, in the conclusion part, to me and to as per the many research findings and the publication that I have reviewed, it is I want to state that the school feeding program is a healthy public policy. It's a healthy public policy, absolutely yes, because there is the modality of the school feeding program is well managed. It has lots of advantage in promoting local agriculture, diversified crop system, community benefits. Moreover, there's access to the healthy food, which has the high nutritional value. And there's moreover with the inclusion of different commodity, like you know, in the which is a very versatile crop, it has a potential increase in the food basket with consideration of health and nutritional status in the country. So with this, I would like to thank each and everyone for your time and listening to my presentation. Thank you so much, and Tashkarichala.